Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the synthesis of ethers from alcohols as starting materials. So in this reaction, it's acid catalyzed. You're going to lose an equivalent of water. So here's the water that I've lost right here. And then you end up sticking these two alkyl chains together through the connection on that oxygen atom. So this is an acid catalyzed reaction. The alcohol in itself is a poor leaving group. And so it's not going to be able to be displaced in the absence of something to make it a better leaving group, and that's where the acid comes in. So you are going to protonate one of the alcohols, and in this case, this is the addition of two of the same alcohol, so it doesn't really matter which one. And in solution, some will be protonated, some won't be protonated. And so that would give us this molecule here. And now I have a good leaving group. That oxygen is positively charged, and so it's going to be not very stable with that positive charge, and so more ready to leave. Now, this still is a primary carbon, and so you're not going to have it leave on its own. Primary carbocations are very unstable, but it is ready to react at this point. And so you're going to have some molecules in solution that are protonated and some that aren't. Those that aren't are going to act as the nucleophiles, and those that are protonated are going to act as the electrophiles. So the lone pair of electrons on the oxygen atom that's neutral on my nucleophile is going to come in to the electrophilic carbon that has the water leaving group on it, and then this bond is going to break and those electrons are going to go onto the oxygen. So this is an SN2 type reaction. Now, generally speaking, SN2 reactions aren't really reversible. In this case, because of the acid, I could go back in the opposite direction by flooding the system with water using Le Chatelier's principle. So I'm still going to use equilibrium arrows here. So now I spit out my equivalent of water. This was my leaving group right here. And then I have my ether, except it's just got a positive charge on it. So the last thing I need to do is deprotonate it. And I can do that using a water molecule or another alcohol that's in solution. Essentially, you really only need a trace amount of acid in solution, and that is going to kind of just be transferred around through different molecules as it catalyzes this reaction. So that deprotonation will give me my final product here, my ether. And then I have an equivalent of H3O+. So H3O+ and H+ are sort of the same thing. The lazy organic chemist is just drawing H+, and that's what you use to protonate. So this H3O+ that we've just generated can be used to protonate another poor leaving group on a starting material alcohol and help catalyze this reaction to completion. Now, in this example, I again have two alcohols, but they are different from one another, and this is going to prove to be problematic. The use of alcohols to make ethers is really only feasible when you're using two equivalents of the same alcohol, because you will get a mixture of products that will be difficult to separate. So I've labeled the alcohols as A and B, and you can imagine that A could either act as the nucleophile or it could have the protonated alcohol that acts as the leaving group, and the same with B. So through this reaction, I could get this molecule. I could also get this molecule, and I could also get this molecule. So I've labeled my alcohols as A and B. The top product is the combination of an A with an A. The middle product is a combination of an A with a B. And it doesn't matter if A or B comes first, that's just kind of flipping the molecule 180 degrees. And then the bottom molecule would be a B with a B. So if I have an asymmetrical system to start with, if I have two different types of alcohols, I'm gonna get a mixture of products. And we purify products based on differences in polarity. So our purification methods, column chromatography, recrystallization, etc., they rely on a difference in polarity between our molecules. And in this case, we really don't have one. All that's different is a little bit of the alkyl chain. So you're gonna end up with a mess on your hands in this case. So it's not a good way to synthesize an ether if you're using two different types of alcohols and you want an asymmetrical ether. Now, we did the mechanism for the last reaction. When you have a primary alcohol, that is gonna go via an SN2 mechanism. It has a unhindered system that is able to have a nucleophilic attack at the same time the leaving group leaves, and a primary carbocation would be unstable. Secondary alcohol is likely to proceed through either SN2 or SN1 type reactions. You might actually see a little bit more SN1 type reactions because of how good of a leaving group that protonated alcohol is. So it makes a water molecule, right? So when we have a proton on it, this oxygen has a positive charge on it. That's a small atom that's electronegative with a localized positive charge. It's going to be very unstable and a pretty good leaving group. And so that's going to make the rate of an SN1 reaction faster. And then last, the tertiary alcohol is definitely going to proceed through an SN1 type mechanism. It's too hindered for a backside attack. It has a very good leaving group, and you get a relatively stable tertiary carbocation. So this has been a look at how to synthesize ethers from two alcohol starting materials. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.